morning, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. This is Ambika presenting on in vitro production of secondary metabolites. Production of secondary metabolites. The process of in vitro culture of cells for large-scale production of secondary metabolites involves seven aspects. That is, selection of cell lines for high yield of secondary metabolites, then large-scale cultivation of plant cells, medium composition and effect of nutrients, elicitin-induced production, and effect of environmental factors, biotransformation, and secondary metabolites release and analysis. Selection of high-yield cell lines, that is, selecting the plant which produces high metabolites, secondary metabolites. There are three techniques, that is, cell cloning and visual or chemical selection and selection for resistance. Cell cloning, making number of copies, many number of copies, only those cells are selected which yield high ability yielding cell lines. Then visual chemical selection, that is identifying cell lines producing colored secondary metabolites, that is pigments like beta carotene, that is golden yellow, and chicorin red, used as dyes and preparation of drugs. Selection for resistance, that is certain plant cells have the ability to resist to some toxic chemicals, may lead to formation of mutant cells. Such mutants producing desired metabolites in large quantities are selected. Example, 5-methyltryptophan produces tryptophan overproducing strains, which in turn synthesizes 10 to 15 times higher levels of natural auxin, that is IAA, indole acetic acid. Cell aggregate cloning, we are selecting plant which is high yielding secondary metabolites. We are surface sterilizing it and inoculating in petri plate in media. We are establishing explant culture, then scalar culture, that is unorganized mass of cells, parenchymatous cells, then selecting high yielding calyx and grown on the fresh medium, and that is subculture. One is for growth and another is for metabolite analysis. And then we are selecting such cells which yield high yielding of secondary metabolites, and we are scale up in suspension culture, then in bioreactor. Large scale production, that is mass production of the plant cells. There are different cultures used: free cell suspension culture, immobilized cell culture, two-phase system culture, Thierry root culture. Free cell suspension culture, mass cultivation of the plant cells, good growth rate of the cells, and efficient formation of the desired secondary metabolites. There are bioreactors, many bioreactors are used, that is batch bioreactor, continuous, airlift, stirred tank bioreactors. Immobilized cell culture, that is encapsulating the high yielding secondary metabolite cells or calyx. To avoid hydrodynamic stress, that is heat produced by the impellers or baffles, then their entrapment, the encapsulation is done by the gels or foams, nets, or hollow fiber membranes. Two-phase system, two upphase phases are of the medium are used. First phase is for the growth and second is for the production of the secondary metabolites. Certain polymers used for separation of the phases, that is example dextrose and polyethylene glycol, used for the separation of phenolic compounds. Then next is hairy root culture, production of the root associated metabolites. Example, material inoculated with cells of pathogenic bacterium, that is Agrobacterium rhizogenes, containing RI plasmid, root-inducing plasmid, which causes genetic transformation resulting in the hairy root culture having metabolite features. Example, Nicotiana tabacum, that is nicotine. Cell suspension culture. Here we are selecting the high yielding secondary metabolite plants, and we are culturing by the suspension cutter, that is liquid medium. Hairy root culture. Here Agrobacterium rhizogenes are the bacteria by which we are incorporating the strains which alters the auxin metabolism, which produces the secondary metabolites. Media composition and effect of nutrients. of the secondary medium, two medium are approached, one for growth, another one for production. Effect of nutrients like carbohydrates or pH also will be altering, and plant growth regulators. Carbohydrates, example sucrose, increase in the sucrose concentration 4 to 10% increases alkaloid production in Cataranthus rhoeticus cultures. Low concentration of sucrose increases the production of ubiquinone-10 in tobacco cell cultures. Effect of plant growth regulators, that is addition of the auxins, that is IAA, indole acetic acid, or IEPA, indole propionic acid, or NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, enhance the production of the histidine in cultures of melanites, HMTFA. Auxins may inhibit production of the secondary metabolites, that is NAA and IAA, inhibit the synthesis of anthocyanin in carrot cultures. Elicitor-induced production. Elicitors are the small organic compounds of biological origin are induced to produce secondary metabolites. Biological origin means they are produced either by the plants or either by the microorganisms. So, the elicitors which produced within the plant cells are endogenous elicitors, and the plants and the elicitors produced by the microorganisms are exogenous elicitors. Endogenous elicitors, example is pectin, pectic acid, cellulose. Exogenous elicitors are chitin, chitinosan, and glucans. There are abiotic elicitors and abiotic elicitors which are produced from the abiotic factors. That is example UV light, cold, heat, osmotic pressure, ethylene, fungicides. They are produced by the chemicals also. Then phytoalexins, chemically defined elicitors. These are the chemical weapons of defense in plants against pathogenic microorganisms. Example actinomycin B, ribonuclease A, sodium salt of arachidonic acid. Example is Aspergillus niger in Cinchona lecterania, Rubia cinchona is an organism, and anthocyanins are the secondary metabolites produced. Effect of environmental factors. Physical factors, that is light, incubation temperature, pH of the medium, and aeration of the culture. Light, here light mediated enzymatic reactions and photosynthesis indirectly influences the secondary metabolites formation. Example, blue light enhances anthocyanin production in Haplotrichum gracilis cell suspension, and white and blue light inhibits naphthoquinone biosynthesis in callus cultures of Lithospermum erythrorhizum. Incubation temperature, growth of the culture cells increased with increase in the temperature up to an optimal temperature, that is 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. Example, increased temperature reduces the production of the caffeine in C. sinensis and nicotine in tobacco. pH, good growth of the culture medium ranges from pH 5 to 6. Production of anthocyanin by cultures of Daucus carota was much less when incubated at 5.5 at pH 4.5 due to increase in degraded anthocyanin at higher pH degradation. Biotransformation, it is the process of transformation of less valuable secondary metabolites into more valuable or useful products having commercial importance. Example, digitalis ligand.